Hey there, I'm Kyle with Microsoft. Let's not waste any time. Here are 10 tips for getting the most out of the chat area within Microsoft Teams. First of all, if you're new to Microsoft Teams, you can check out our entire playlist of Teams tutorial videos here, and our specific video introducing chat here. And as always, like and subscribe for even more content like this. Chat is the perfect place to have one-on-one conversations or group conversations that aren't about a specific topic, while channels within Teams are great for announcements and conversations about specific projects, chat is your persistent, instant message thread with your teammates. If you always want a particular conversation readily available, you can pin a chat to the top of this list. Select the ellipses and then select pin. You can reorganize pinned chats by dragging them. Selecting the word chat at the top can switch the view to the contacts list. By default, the only contact group is favorites, but new contact groups can be created from the bottom of the list. Give the group a name and then start adding individuals to that new group. Back in the chat list, there's also the option to filter your list of chats. Clicking Filter lets you search for a specific name, and also gives the options to filter by unread messages, muted conversations, and chats tied to specific meetings. Let's take a look at a unique option when you're formatting a message in a chat. Selecting the exclamation point lets you change how others in the chat are notified of your message. Important sends a notification via Teams based on your recipient's notification settings, but urgent is where things get really intense. A notification is sent every 2 minutes for 20 whole minutes, including notifications via email. Urgent for when you really need someone's attention. Chats can be one-on-one or group conversations, but you can add people to a conversation at any time. Selecting the people icon in the top right will show you the current members of the chat and give the option to add more people. When deciding to add a new team member, you can choose how much of the chat history to let them see. All, none, or a select number of days. A long-running conversation can get complicated, especially in a group. If you need to reply directly to a specific message, just hover over that message, select the ellipses, and choose the first option, reply. This will quote the original message in your new message. Once posted, clicking that quoted message will take you to the context of the original post. There are a bunch of icons underneath the message formatting box here, but one unique to chats is loops. This lets you post an element like a checklist, a table, or a paragraph, and more that everyone in the chat can edit. Perfect for, say, building a contact list or assigning tasks for an upcoming project. Chats are the perfect place to express yourself. You can find emojis, stickers, and animated GIFs right next to loops underneath the message box. Finally, sometimes you just need to multitask. If you need to chat with multiple people in different conversations, just look for the pop-out button, either in the top right corner or by hovering over that chat in your list. You can have as many open Teams chat windows as you need. What's your favorite feature inside of Microsoft Teams? Why don't you let us know down in the comments below, and we'll talk to you next time.
Want to learn more? Check out ExpertZone, Microsoft's online learning platform. Take courses, complete accreditations, and earn achievements and prizes like codes for Microsoft 365 Family, Xbox Game Pass Ultimate, and more.